Hare Krishna. So today we will talk about who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. According to the scriptures, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is none other than Radha and Krishna. He is the combined incarnation of Radha and Krishna in the age of Kali. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a Channa avatar, or nobody can easily recognize him to be the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But he came as a devotee to teach everyone the true aspect of devotional service. As Krishna instructed many things about devotional service in Bhagavad Gita, but nobody was practicing. That is why as a avatar Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, this incarnation, Krishna took this incarnation to teach us the process of devotional service and what is the true Madhurya Rasa and the Vrindavan Ras. How can we go back to Golok Vrindavan by practicing devotional service? That was taught by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So before accepting anyone to be a incarnation of avatar of the Supreme Lord, there must be scriptural references or predictions about that avatar. Like in case of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there are so many scriptural predictions. Without these scriptural predictions, we cannot accept someone as an incarnation of the Supreme Lord. And also there are many signs, like in the hands and footprints of that personality, there will be some auspicious signs. So these are the symptoms or signs that that personality is an incarnation of the Supreme Lord. So we'll check what are the references in scriptures about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Chapter 5, Text Number 32, it is mentioned, Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishnam Sangha Pangostra Parshadam Yagyai Sankirtanai Prayai Jajanti Hi Sumedhasa. So this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will take incarnation in Kali Yuga, and Krishna Varnam, he will utter the holy names of Krishna, and Tvisha Akrishnam, and he will have a golden complexion, and his only business will be Yagyai Sankirtanai Prayai. He will preach this Harinam Sankirtana Yagya. And Jajanti Hi Sumedhasa, only the intelligent devotees can understand him. In the Garuda Puran, it is mentioned, Yore me sahaballavi ramayate brindavane harnisam yakam samni jaganakura varane japandavanam sakha soyam vaishnava danda mandita vujo sanyasa veshashvayam nishandeha mupagata shititale chaitanya rupa prabhu. So that Krishna who is to enjoy Madhurya Leela with the gopis of Vrindavan, and that Krishna who was the killer of Kamsa and who became friend of the Pandavas in the Mahabharata Kurukshetra war, that same Krishna has assumed this form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as a Vaishnava sannyasi, and there is no doubt in this fact. In Garuda Puran it is also mentioned, Kale Prathama Sandhayam Lakshmikanto Bhavishyati Daru Brahma Samipastha Sanyasi Gaura Vigraha. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will reside near the temple of Jagannath Puri, that is also mentioned in Garuda Puran. In Nrisimha Puran it is mentioned, Satya Daitya Kuladhinasa Samaye Simhorda Martyakritis Tretayam Dasakandharam Paribhavan Rameti Namakritis Gopalan Paripalayan Brajapure Bharam Haram Dvapare Gauranga Priya Kirtane Kalijuke Chaitanya Nama Prabhu. So that Supreme Lord who assumed the half lion, half man incarnation of Nrisimhadev in the Satya Yuga to kill Hiranyakashipu, that same Supreme Lord assumed the form of Ramachandra in the Treta Yuga to kill Ravana. And as Krishna, he maintained the Vrindavan Vasis or the Brajavasis in the Dwapar Yuga, and he killed many demons and established religion. That same Krishna, the Supreme Lord, has appeared in this fallen age of Kali as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who will preach this cult of Harinam Sankirtan. Now there are various reasons why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took incarnation. Some of the reasons are external and some are internal. So the external reasons are, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to renovate the pastime places of Radha and Krishna, because the pastimes of Radha Krishna happened about 5000 years ago and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came around 500 years ago. So during that time all the places, pastime places, were not in proper condition so that people can recognize. Therefore, he wanted to renovate those places and he wanted to write Vaishnava literature of this Gaudiya Vaishnavism philosophy. He wanted to build many temples. Like we see, the Goswamis, there are in Vrindavan, there are temples of the Goswamis. Radha Madan Mohan for Sanatan Goswami, Radha Gobindji for Rupa Goswami, Radha Damodar for Jiva Goswami. And the six Goswamis also wrote many literatures like Bhakti Rasamrit Sindhu, Hari Bhakti Vilas, Ujjwala Nilmani, Lalit Madhav, Bidagdha Madhav and many. So, and another reason was he wanted, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to establish this Vaishnava etiquettes through the Goswamis, which they exemplified. And the internal reason behind why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took the incarnation, means Krishna took the incarnation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which is the combined form of Radha Krishna, is to taste the devotional sentiments of Srimati Radharani, who is considered to be the greatest devotee of Krishna. So Krishna wanted to know that how a devotee feels when he is serving the Supreme Lord. So in the Chaitanya Charitamrit Adi Lila, chapter 1, text number 6, it is mentioned, Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrisho Vanayaiva Sadhyo Yen Adbhuta Madhurima Kidrisha Ba Madhiya Saukhyam Chasa Madanubhavataha Kidrisham Veti Lovat Tadbhavadhyam Samajani Sachi Garva Sindhu Harindu. So Krishna took this incarnation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to taste or understand the devotional sentiments of Radharani and how Radharani feels when Krishna reciprocates with him, with her. So these were the reason behind why Krishna took the incarnation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and this incarnation is called magnanimous or Mahabadanaya incarnation, because in this incarnation Krishna came as a devotee and he did not carry any weapon. So this incarnation was not meant to annihilate the miscreants but to destroy their sinful propensity from their heart by the weapon of Harinam Sankirtan. So as predicted, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will preach this Harinam Sankirtan movement. From the very birth of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we can see this fact that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth during a lunar eclipse when throughout India there was chanting of the holy names. When an auspicious situation appears, people generally chant the holy names. So among the magnanimous chanting of the holy name, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in this planet. And also in his childhood pastimes, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a baby and he used to cry, there was only one remedy to stop his crying, that was to chant the holy names. So he is teaching from the very childhood that I have taken incarnation to make all you people chant. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu predicted that this chanting of the holy names will be spread all over the world. Prithivite jato acha nagaradi gram sarvatra prachara haibe moranam. And that is being done by ISKCON, by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada. That is why Prabhupada is called the Senapati Bhakta of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So this Harinam Sankirtan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was stressing upon this Harinam Sankirtan again and again, and he encouraged this very much. He quoted the verse from Bihan Naradiya Puran, Harir Nama, Harir Nama, Harir Nama Iba Kevalam, Kalo Nasteva, 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 Gatiranatha. That means, in this fallen age of Kali, the only way to for deliverance is chanting the holy names. There is no other way, there is no other way, there is no other way. And with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his four prime associates, whom we know as Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, Gadadhar Pandit and Srivash Pandit. So along with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his four intimate associates, they are called Panchatattva. So by their mercy, we got this holy name. Therefore, before beginning our chanting, we chant the Panchatatra Mahamantra also, which is Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivashadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So please chant this Mahamantra and be happy. Thank you. Hare Krishna.